The worldwide epidemiology of MS is converging to the identification of some major risk factor that could contribute to prevent many cases of MS. So the main risk factor are vitamin D deficiency that increases the risk of MS, obesity during adolescence associated also with an increased risk of MS, smoking behavior, and even more strongly than the previous one, infection with the Epstein-Barr virus. So the data are consistent between Europe, the US, Canada, and Australia, and the suggestion that by acting on this risk factor, we could prevent a large proportion of MS cases. The Institute of Medicine in the United States has set a 50 nanomole, che corrisponde to 20 nanogram per ml, as a what is considered a healthy level. But what has been found in studies within the US that actually higher blood level, well above 50 nanomole, up to 100 nanomole and over, are associated with a lower risk of developing MS. We don't have a specific level that we can say is optimal. It looks like the higher the vitamin D level within the physiological range, the lower the risk of MS. So many healthy individuals in our population have a level that is below the optimal for MS prevention. The latitude is strongly correlated with UV light exposure, and is less strongly correlated with the vitamin D level, because vitamin D level depend not only on the latitude where you live, but also a lot on your behavior, you know, how much you are outdoor, the physical activity, use of sunscreen. So when we try to explain the latitude gradient in terms of vitamin D, we can only explain a little bit of it. And a big question on the latitude gradient also that has been changing over time, has been sort of disappearing. It's possible that this is because of changes in behavior, so that the vitamin D level now at lower latitude is not as high as it used to be because people work indoor and use sunscreen. That's a possible explanation, but we don't really have a definitive answer on what has been driving the change in latitude gradient in MS. So the increase in incidence of MS in black men and women in the US is quite striking. I think it's a pretty solid finding. It's not a recent, very recent increase. At least we don't know what is happening in the last few years. But this is a conclusion that has been based on a comparison between veterans from the Second World War, compared with younger generations. And in our own study, we've been looking at US nurses born before 1946 or after 1946. So the increase in African American